Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo of someone into a stunning transitional watercolor painting and how to apply it automatically to other photos without having to redo all the effects. Open a photo of someone. I downloaded this one and the others from Shutterstock.com. Click off the lock icon to unlock the layer. Let's name the layer Base. To effect the photo non-destructively and to allow us to edit the effects that we add to it, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object when this icon is added to the lower right corner of the thumbnail. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Let's name it Smart Blur. Go to Filter, Blur, and Smart Blur. I'll choose a radius of 10, the threshold 20, and the quality High. Keep in mind, depending on the size and resolution of your photo, you may want to adjust these amounts until your image looks similar to the preview here. Then click OK. Click the thumbnail of the base to make the layer active. Make a copy of it and name it Pencil Lines. Drag the layer to the top of the Layers panel. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Stylize folder and click Glowing Edges. I'll make the Edge Width 1, the Edge Brightness 15, and the Smoothness 15. However, feel free to adjust these amounts. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Invert. Click the Clipping Mask icon, which clips or restricts the adjustment layer to only affect the pencil lines layer. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click black-white. This desaturates the colors from the layer. Clip it and change the blend mode to multiply. Reduce its opacity to between 50 to 60%. Make the pencil lines layer active and change its blend mode to multiply as well. To save space in the Layers panel, let's group all the pencil lines layers into its own folder. To do this, shift-click on the top layer to highlight all the pencil lines layers and press Ctrl or Command-G. Name the folder Pencil Lines. To save even more space, let's hide the smart filter by clicking the small triangle on the right. The filter is there, it's just hidden from view. Make the smart blur layer active and make a copy of it. Let's name it Brush. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Invert. Clip it and change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Click the gear icon and click Reset Brushes. When you see this message, click OK to replace the current brushes with the default brushes. Click back on the gear icon and check Small List. Scroll to the bottom and click Dry Brush, then press Enter or Return. To make your brush larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Reduce the opacity to 30%. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Now, brush quickly over your image. At this point, the texture will be very subtle. Click back on your brush picker, and this time, click Rough Round Bristle. Increase its opacity to 100%. Adjust the size of your brush and brush over portions of your image. Notice when you overlap strokes, those areas become darker and richer, just like true watercolor paint. If you're not happy with the paint strokes, just undo it and brush back in as many variations as you want. Next, we'll make the colors more vibrant. Make the pencil lines folder active. Above it, we'll place an adjustment layer. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. Drag the slider to the right. I'll make mine +85. Next, we'll add a watercolor paper texture. Go to the pencil lines layer and click the arrow to open the folder. Click the thumbnail to make the layer active. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the texture folder and click Texturizer. Choose Sandstone. Make the scaling 50%, the relief 3, and the light from the top. Then click OK. Your portrait now has a watercolor paper texture. Next, I'll show you how to quickly replace the person in the portrait with a different person without having to redo all the effects. Go to any smart object and double-click it. This opens the original image before any of the effects were applied to it. Go to File and Place Embedded. Locate the folder that contains a photo of the other person. Click the image and click Place. Go to a corner and press Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out, then press Enter or Return. Remove the base by either trashing it or by merging the layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Close the Smart Object document by clicking on the small X on the right of the tab. Click Yes to save the changes. Automatically, the Smart Objects in the Layers panel updated all the effects to the new photo. At this point, all we have to do is remove the painted areas that were specific to the first image and brush in areas that are specific to this image. To do this, scroll to the layer mask, make it active, and fill it with white by pressing Ctrl or Command plus Delete. As before, open your brush picker, click Dry Brush, and reduce its opacity to 30%. Adjust your brush's size, and quickly brush over your image. Open your brush picker again, and as before, click the Rough Rounded Bristle. Make the opacity 100%, and brush over your image to complete your portrait. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.